Hello and welcome to the second week of the OracleJet course. The theme of the first week was architecture, modularity, and data binding. At this point, you should have an understanding of the kinds of enterprise problems that JET helps you to solve. You should also understand the basics of existing open source enterprise solutions that relate to modularity and data binding provided by Require.js and Knockout.js. You should have done some coding in NetBeans IDE or in another tool while getting comfortable with the creation of JET applications. If you've created a few basic JET applications, added some modules, integrated a few Oracle JET components from the cookbook, you are now ready to continue with the second week of the course. The theme of the second week is to explore Oracle JET's features, use cases, and scenarios. By the end of this week, you'll have explored the Oracle JET component library. You also have explored techniques for dealing with navigation, routing, validation, page layout, and responsive design. You will wrap up the week by exploring hybrid mobile application development with Oracle JET. By the end of the week, you should have the full range of Oracle JET coding techniques and components at your disposal and be able to comfortably create attractive Oracle JET applications. Let's start by highlighting the main features of the Oracle JET website. OracleJET.org provides everything you need, whether you are learning and getting started with Oracle JET, or whether you are being productive, creating new applications, setting up your environment, and coding for production purposes. The Get Started page shows you how to set everything up, using the command line interface to create new applications, whether for web applications or for hybrid mobile development. The cookbook lists all of the components that Oracle JET makes available, and for each component, you will see that there is a recipe with a lot of related documentation. You will also see that there is a Learn section on the Oracle JET homepage, where the tutorials, the hands-on lab, templates, and other related resources are found. The Success Stories page is a showcase of what organizations around the world are doing with JET. Once you start using JET in production yourself, your organization is invited to make this kind of information available to promote JET usage and to show others what you are doing with it. Finally, the support page provides access to a forum where you can ask questions, as well as an FAQ, a blog, videos, and a range of supporting resources. Take special note of the developer guide, which provides a lot of detailed information covering a range of typical questions and problems you are likely to face, such as how to design responsive applications, how to set up single-page application architectures, and these kinds of concerns. We're going to be focusing on data visualization components and data collection components in the next parts of this course. Be aware that, aside from those components, there are several others. The form components, button components, image components, menu components. These work as you might expect and have been included in Oracle JET so that all the user interface components in your JET application will have the same kind of behavior and appearance in terms of accessibility, internationalization, and how they will look to the end user. In this, the first part of the second week, you have been introduced to the topics that will be covered during this week. You have also been given a tour through OracleJET.org, and you should now be fully aware of all the resources that are available to you to support you in your work with JET. For your homework for this part, spend a little time reviewing the OracleJET.org website and get comfortable with what is available in each section. Look at the different categories of components in the cookbook so that you can quickly find the component that you are looking for in the future. And with that, we thank you for participating in the Oracle JET course and look forward to having you again in the next part.